welcome to Zaraku with me, Zara from Indonesia. So guys, in this video, I want to tell you about a woman that's so popular as female vampire.
Wow!
And this history is real history from Transylvania, Romania. I have reacted to Dracula versus Sultan Mehmed II in my previous video. So if you have not watched my previous video, you can watch my video. The link is right here. Yeah, the Dracula also from Transylvania, Romania. And now I want to tell you about the female vampire, and she is Elizabeth Bathory. She is very cruel and scary woman.
Wow!
So do you know guys that Elizabeth Bathory and also Plattip are separated by more than a century, but united in the reputation they developed outside the Eastern Europe for cruelty, brutality, and bloodthirstiness. Wow. Torture, bloodbath, vampires, and hundreds of victims, it is all attached to the name of Elizabeth Bathory, a countess, a title of nobility, wife of a count, who lived in the Kingdom of Hungary in the 16th and 17th centuries. The Bathory family is remembered for its defense against the Ottomans. She is best known as a serial killer in Hungarian and Slovak history, and is remembered as the Bloody Women of Sece. Ashtis Palace is where she spent her life. Elizabeth has tortured and killed more than 650 women with the help of servants. For that, Guinness World Records gave her the nickname Most Prolific Female Murderer. The page also states that Bathory drank and bathed in the blood of her victims in order to stay young. Elizabeth Bathory, in Hungarian spelling Erzsébet Bathory, was born in 1560 to a prominent Protestant noble family. Her family controlled the Transylvania region that would later become part of Romania and was often associated with vampires due to the story of the Dracula. When she reached the age of 15, Bathory was married to Conference to Nadesti. This marriage was referred to as a political agreement in aristocratic circles. Due to the higher social strata of the family, instead of using her husband's name, Elizabeth kept her last name Bathory. Nadesti's wedding gift to the Bathory was a castle in the Carpathian mountain range, Sece Castle, where his wife would later spend the rest of her life in prison. In 1578, Nadesti left his wife to become the main commander of the Hungarian army in the military campaign against the Ottoman Empire. Bathory then became the sole person in charge of the Fez territory as well as governing the local population. Since then, rumors that Bathory abused maids and a number of women began to surface. According to witnesses, Bathory's victims were poor girls. They were lured into the castle with the lure of work. This assumption became even more horrendous when Nadesti died in 1604. In 1610, the then king of Hungary, Matthias II, ordered Georg to investigate the allegation. Terzo was a prominent figure who served as the Palatine of the Hungary, a kind of high-ranking official of the kingdom. In addition, he is also Bathory's cousin, and it's believed that Prince Nadesti will provide protection for his wife when the commander realized that he will no longer live long. Between March and July 1610, Terzo's men interviewed 52 witnesses, and 34 of whom were servants of the countess. Various reports and testimonies say Bathory put the victims into a torture device called the Iron Maiden, burned them, beat them to death with stick, pour ice water over their bodies, and let them freeze. It is also said to cover the bodies of victims with honey so that their skin is eaten by insects. Bathory was also reported to have beaten pieces of flesh from the chest and faces of the victims. After hearing the accusations, Terzo finally charged Bathory with the deaths of 80 girls. The number of victims, estimates at 650 people, emerged from a servant named Susanna, who claimed to have seen her employer's diary, which lists the names of all victims. Bathory herself was confined to Sussex Castle for the rest of her life until 1614. She died at the age of 54. The ruins of the castle are now a tourist attraction in an area that falls into the territory of Slovakia known as Ashtis Castle. Alright guys, that is the scary history of Elizabeth Bathory. Wow, I think she's really obsessed with her beauty.
Okay guys, kali ini aku mau membagikan tips skincare rutin aku yang bikin kulit aku lembut dan putih. Aku pakai produk body care dari Scarlett. Pertama, aku pakai body scrub dari Scarlett. Ini varian coffee. Ini tuh termasuk varian yang terbaru ya dari body scrub Scarlett. Nah, kalian bisa lihat kan, ini teksturnya lembut banget. Scrubnya itu nggak nyakitin kulit gitu. Ini lembut banget, jadi nyaman banget dipakai ke kulit. Aku selalu pakai ini sebelum mandi. Tuh, ini lembut banget. Kalau udah diaplikasikan semuanya, tinggal tunggu 3 menit lalu bilas. Nah, ini dia hasilnya. Selanjutnya, aku langsung mandi pakai shower scrub dari Scarlett. Ini varian terbaru juga, varian Jolly. Ini tuh variannya itu sama kayak body lotionnya. Teksturnya benar-benar lembut, scrubnya itu lembut dan tidak menyakiti kulit. Nah, ini dia hasilnya, makin cerah kan? Selanjutnya, untuk melindungi kulit aku pakai body lotion dari Scarlett, varian Jolly. Ini variannya sama kayak shower scrub aku ya, tadi Jolly. Ini teksturnya lembut banget, tapi tidak lengket di kulit, dan ini ringan banget, jadi nyaman banget kalau pakai body lotion. Tuh kan, beda banget kan, yang pakai Scarlett itu lebih cerah dan sehat. Aku beli produk body care Scarlett ini dari Shopee. Link Shopee Scarlett bisa kalian lihat di Instagram official Scarlett.
Alright guys, thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to like, comment, and also subscribe. Okay, see you in the next video.